So, good afternoon. We will study today estimation and costing by and I am Avinash. So, we will study today estimation and costing. So, contents. We have already studied this one in last lecture, the introduction of the estimations, the types of estimations, methods of estimation, and we have done one numerical over there. These are the introduction we have already seen in the last class. The metric system, the objectives, the accurate estimate and all. The types of estimates, preliminary, plinth, cubic, rate, approximate. Detailed, revised, supplementary, annual repair. So we have seen all these estimates in detail, one by one, in last class. And we have also seen these two methods, long wall, short wall, and central line method. And we have discussed about partly central line and short wall method. So now, today we will do some numericals over the various methods which we have learned in last lecture. So suppose there is a question given that a contractor constructs a building with given parameter. These parameters are given. Plinth area is given. Cost is given. Height of building from floor level to roof level is given. We have to determine the cost of a similar building of plinth area equals to 135 square meter using plinth area method and cubic length method as well. So we have to proceed from now. So the answer of this numerical will be, first we will calculate the we have plinth area, and now we will calculate the cost of this cost of the plot per square meter. First of all, we will say divide by 100. So this value is cost per square meter. So with this 100 meter square meter plot, which is at a cost of 95,000 rupees, we will get around 950 rupee per square meter. So here we got 950 square rupees, 950 per square meter. Now the height of building from the floor level to roof is given 3.5, and here we got cost per square meter 950. So now what we have determined, the cost area equals to 135 square meter. Per square meter we got the value 950. Now we have to find the value of 135 square meters. So 950 will be multiplied by 135, because the similar building, because the building is similar, that's why that 135 into 950 equals to 1,28,000 approximately. So this is the cost of cost of the similar building. So we have used this method, the plinth area method, to quantify or to just take to get the value of the in monetary terms the cost of similar building of 135 square meter. Suppose we have to do the same numerical with using cubic rate method. Now what we have to do? So, using the cubic rate method, we have to just first of all find out the area, the volume of the plot. So what is the volume of plot? The volume of plot will be 100 square meter into 3.5 meter. Which will be around 350. Cube. So with this cubic rate method we have found the volume. Now this much volume comes in rupee 95,000. So 1 meter. So 1 meter will be 1 meter cube will be 95,123 divided by 350. So 1 meter cube equals to 95,000 divided by 350. So that per meter cube value will be 35. So this will be the rupee for 1 meter cube. And now we have to find out the volume of this much square meter. So for 1 meter cube, this is the volume. And how much volume comes in 135 square meter? So 135 square meter into 1. Into 3.5 meter, the value, the height of the roof. So we got some value, let's say B value. We got B. Now the B meter cube. Now 1 meter cube has this much value, so how much will be B cube? So for B meter cube, 9500 by 35 into B will be the value of the similar building through cubic rate method. Now we'll go for second. So now the plan of excavation is shown in the figure. The figure is this one. This one. The depth of excavation is 500 deep. So the plan of figure is this, and the depth of excavation is 500 mm deep. Estimate the excavation quantity with explanation and draw the cross sections of both the walls. So for this numerical, we have to draw the cross section for this wall and this wall, and we have to calculate the quantity, excavation quantity. So we will be starting with number one, cross sections. And we have already got the breadth here, breadth is 50 mm, and here is 800 mm. So these all are in mm. These all are in mm. Now we have to draw a cross section here for this. So the cross section at XX will be. Here we go. And the depth will be 500. So the depth will be 500. Now here cross section will be 750. This will be, and this depth will be 500. And these are the two cross sections we have to draw at XS and at YY. So at XS this is, and at XYY the same exactly. This will be duplicated here. So this is the depth, and this is the value of 750, the depth 500 mm. Now we have drawn the cross section, so we have just done the first part of the second part of this. Now we have to go with the first part, estimate the excavation quantity with explanation. So now for this second is so here bit they have given the bit. Now we will first of all apply the long hole short hole method, and for this we'll get the quantity like let's say C. SN items number length breadth depth quantity. For excavation quantity, first number that we have to get is excavation earthwork. So how many long wall are there? There will be two long walls, one this and one this. Okay, and the long walls are this one, and these two are short wall. So this long wall, this has out-to-out length of 550, which is already given, so we don't have to find again same. So for this this thing, they have already given the out-to-out length, which is 5500. So these are two in number and having 5500 mm. Already given outdoor, we don't have to do again the same thing. And then breadth of this is given, this is a long wall, and the breadth is given 750. Okay, and the depth of the foundation is given 500. So the quantity will be multiplication of 5900 into 750 into 500. So this will be the quantity for earthwork for long wall. So this will be 2 into 5500 into 750 into 500. Now for short wall. Now for short wall, there are two long walls and there are two short walls as well. So two short walls. Short walls length will be into in. So here we will calculate from here to here, but we have given the value from out to out, so we will minus this much value, 750 and 750. So here we will get the value. For example, let's see first to find out the center. Here we will find out the center to center length. So here, how much will be center center length for the long wall? It will be from here 400 minus, from here 400 minus. So we minus 400 from here. So it will be 800 minus here will be 47. So the center center length will be 4700 for long wall. And the length for a short wall, center center length for short wall will be, if it is 3300 this much, so we will minus this much, it will be 350 and 350. So we will minus 1 width. So if we minus 1 width here, it will be 750. So 3300 to minus 750. So it will be around 25. So 3300 minus 750. So it will be around 2550. So it will be 2550 mm. So this center center will be 2550 again up to minus 1 bit because it is a short wall, and short wall you have to take from in to in, so long wall will take out to out. So in to in will be again up to minus 750. Will be 0 0 18. So again the value of this wall, short wall, came 1800. So you have to write here 1800 mm. The short wall width will be 800. The width of short wall will be, short wall width will be 800, and this will be 500. So it will be around 2 into 800 into 800 500, plus to the quantity. So we have calculated the quantities for earthwork, for long wall and short wall. This the quantity, total quantity of long wall and short wall. This question we cannot do this question with center line method. Why? Because we have the center line value, but again we don't have the depth throughout this. Throughout this plan, we don't have an equal depth, like equal width. This width is not equal. Depth is equal, but width is not equal. So if width is not equal, we cannot calculate with center line method, because this method is for symmetrical plans, not for the asymmetrical. Now we will move for the next numerical. So the next numerical is given cross section, the construction is given, and the plan of the wall of 5 meters is given. Prepare the estimate of quantities for the following: the earthwork in excavation foundation, lime concrete in foundation, first class brickwork in foundation, and plinth, and 2.5 cm for BPC. So this is the cross section, and we will find out one by one with the help of long wall, short wall method. So we are forming then items, then number L, B, D. Okay, now I will have this serial number will be like very small, where we can accommodate. Now, so the question is, we have to find the earthwork for excavation of 5 meter wall. So we write the wall. Now, first of all, we'll go for excavation. So we have only one wall as per the plan. That wall is one. The length of the plan, the wall of length is 5 meter. The width item for estimation of earthwork is here, this one, because we are at water level, so it is 0.7. Again, the depth will be from ground level to bottom. So ground level to bottom is 30, 20, 50, 90. So we got again 9 meter. So multiply all these values to get the quantities. Now, second, lime concrete. So for lime concrete, so we have lime concrete in foundation. We'll get again. We have one wall only. So one number. Wall's length is 5 meter. The width is same, 0.7. But this time the depth will be 20 centimeter. Because we are finding our lime concrete. Now, third one. The third one is, again, you have to find the brickwork in first footing. So for, let's say, brickwork, brickwork number one, first footing. So this is the first footing, and here we are finding the brickwork. Again, brickwork for one length 5 meter. B, the width value again will be 50 centimeters, so it will be 0.5, and the depth will be 0.2. This is the first footing. For the second footing, it will be again 1. This is second footing, again 1, 5 meter, 0.4, this one, and again this one, 0.2. So quantity we can get by multiplying all these things. Now, once again, for the 1, 2, so we don't have any third footing. So again, for the plinth wall, because the brickwork are founding in foundation and plinth wall. So plinth wall, only one number for a length of wall, which is 5 meter. And again, here we will just see the depth will be of plinth wall to plinth level. So from it will be from here, this value, to this value. So this is 30 plus 60, so it is 90. So the width is 30 centimeter, 0.3, and the depth is 0.9. And now here we can get the value for the plinth wall. Now after this, we got brickwork in foundation plinth wall. We again will go for the brickwork . So we have just found out the first class brickwork in foundation plane. Now we'll go for 2.5 cm of DPC. Now, for DPC, so item will be 2.5 cm DPC. So DPC is only one, so we'll get one here. And the length of DPC, so we are having DPC here at this point. This is DPC, it took 2.5 cm. So the length of that DPC will be throughout the wall. So we calculate the DPC with in square meter. So it's a quantity which is being quantified in area. So we have one number, length will be 5, width we know that it is for 20 centimeter, and then there will be no depth. Why? Because it's already been prescribed as 2.5 centimeter. So we'll get the value. So this is how we get the DBC, and here is how this numerical got completed. We already got the three quantities. We got one earthwork, second line concrete, third first brickwork, and fourth 2.5 centimeter of DBC. Now we'll move with the fourth and last question of today, because we have already completed almost each type of questions and almost each type of building, or the simplest building we can have. In this, we estimate the following quantities from the given figure, which is given under 2. Now, we are here at the last question of today in numerical part under estimation costing. The last question we have today is, estimate the following quantities from the given figure, which is given in the below figure 2, for a room having internal dimensions as 6000 mm into 4000 mm and one door opening of size 1000 into 2100 mm. We have to calculate the excavation foundation, lime concrete foundation, first class brick working foundation, and plinthing foundation. So we move towards this. So here we have to found out this. Now we must know first of all the room, and we must draw the plan of this first. So what will be the internal dimension? 6400 4000 mm. So we have a room like this, which have only one gate. Like this. And here the internal dimensions are 6000 and 4000. So 6000 will be this one, and 4000 will be this one, mm, and the door will be that much. So now what will we do here? We have to calculate once again the same thing. So we will write the same. Now, first, you have to calculate first earthwork in. So, one earthwork. Earthwork. So, that earthwork, now we have a room. So, we have room with two short walls, two long walls. Okay? So, in one long wall, we have this much width of door. That is 100 into 2100. So that door 2100 is the height of the door, and is this small length of the door. So this length is this much of the door, and so we can say it's 1000. Okay. Now earthwork. We are going for earthwork. Here the depth, the width of this wall is 230 mm. Earthwork. Earthwork is we have two walls and we have a thickness of wall internal dimension. So six long wall will be 6000 plus one this width. They are two in numbers. Width of this wall at foundation is this much, which is 900 mm once again. So it will be 90 cm, 0.9. So we will go for 900 only. We are dealing in mm. Then the depth will be 150, 150, 150, 300. So 300 plus 300 plus 300. Again, 900. So after multiplying, we get the quantity of the earthwork in this. Again, yeah, this is earthwork in long wall and again in short wall. Short wall again two in numbers is 400,000. 4000 minus. See this 4000 as short wall, we have to minus from the center to center length. So in this center to center already we got the thickness of this hole. The thickness is 230 of the wall and we are dealing it. So we have to plus here 900. And here at center to center we have to minus this much. So here if we find out the center to center length, it will be around 900 center to center is 1 full width. So center center is 4000 plus 230 and for long wall 6000 plus 230. And now here we have to center center length. In center center length we have to add this one. So this will be around 6230 plus 900 and that will be around 4230 minus 900 because it's a short wall. Then again the length will be same 900 and we get the value. So this is excavation length, which is 6230. And this is 4230. Now at one at second earthwork in foundation you have taken, lime concrete in excavation. So here again it will be for long wall short wall method only. So for long wall again 2 in length, and the length will be same, 6230 plus 900. The width will be same, 900. Just depth will be 150. Quantity will come for short wall again 2 4230 minus 900. Again it will be 900, and it is again 50. This where it will come. Now third one. Third one is first class brickwork foundation and plinth. So first class brickwork. First class brickwork. Again, you have to find out the long wall for, let's say, for first footing. For this one, first footing, long wall will be 580. There are two long walls, and the length of that will be 6230 plus 580, and the depth will be 150. And the width will be 580. So we'll get the value. Likewise for the second to this one, second 460, 6230 plus 460, the width is 460, the again 150 value will come. Likewise for the third one, number for the third footing, 1 2 3 50, two numbers 6230 plus 350, again the width will be 350, and the depth is 150. Yes, so the value, we'll add all these values for the long wall. If you have to calculate the short wall values, for short wall, once again you have to go to the it will be first footing, two in numbers, length of the short wall 4230 minus at this one 580 minus one width, and again this will be width will be 580 and 150. So this is the value again. Now for the second footing, minus 460. The breadth is 460 and the depth is 150. So this will come again same for the third footing for short wall. Third footing, the upper one 2 4230 minus 350 and 150. So this is how we get six different properties. We'll add these three, and then when we add this total. Now after the line concrete and brick work, we have left with plinth work. Plinth wall, again to plinth wall we have long wall, two in numbers, 6230 plus the width of this one, this is a width wall. So width of this one, which is 230, depth is 300, we'll get the value. For short wall, toe in number 4230 minus 230 and 300. So again you got this value, add these two, this is the width wall value, add all these things, you get the quantity of that particular figure. So this is how we calculate the earthwork estimate, the quantities of earthwork and lime concrete and brickwork and foundation using short wall, long wall and central line method. We have done enough numericals on long wall, short wall method. In next class we will do with some one or two numericals with central line method. We are not that much able to do central line method, because that for that we need a symmetrical building, and that central line method is good for a symmetrical building, but we can use that into a part of that building. So we'll see in the next class.